have learned about the important punctuation mark called apostrophe. Apostrophe is generally used to show the possession of nouns and to show the omission of letters. So apostrophe basically makes a sentence shorter, either by helping in omission of letters or by showing possession. In that case, it reduces certain words. This is apostrophe. It looks similar to a comma, but a comma is generally placed after a word at the bottom, whereas an apostrophe is placed after a word at the top. So an apostrophe and comma, they look the same, but the difference lies in where they are put. If it is at the top, it is an apostrophe. If it is at the bottom, it is a comma. So let us see how we can use apostrophe. Have a look at this interesting paragraph. Amit has a dog. The dog of Amit is very cute. Amit and his friends play with the dog of Amit. Now, while I'm reading this paragraph, this phrase, the dog of Amit, the dog of Amit, is being repeated again and again. And although it is absolutely correct in terms of grammar to write a sentence like this, but it is somewhat odd to hear and inconvenient to write such long phrases. Now, since the dog belongs to Amit, it is the dog of Amit, and the dog belongs to Amit. So we can do something over here. We can attach this dog to Amit using a hook. So we can attach the dog to Amit using a hook, and this hook in English grammar is called the apostrophe. So wherever we have this phrase, the dog of Amit, I can write Amit's dog, Amit, hook, and then an S, and then I can write dog, Amit's dog. So this paragraph can be written as Amit has a dog. Now instead of the dog of Amit, I write Amit's dog is very cute. Amit and his friends play with, once again, instead of the dog of Amit, I write Amit's dog. So now you can see, using this hook, we have been able to make the sentence concise and short, and now it is easy to read and write this sentence. So Amit's dog means that the dog is possessed by Amit, or the dog belongs to Amit. That is why we use this hook-like thing. This hook-like thing is a very important punctuation mark, and it is called the apostrophe. It looks like a comma. In fact, it is very similar to a comma, but it is placed at the top. So apostrophe is generally used to show the possession of nouns or pronouns and to show the omission of letters. Apostrophe is also used for short forms. So apostrophe is generally used to shorten or make things concise, either by showing belonging, just like we used Amit's dog in place of the dog of Amit, or at times it is used to shorten two words by making them into a single word. We will see how. So now let us see how we can rewrite this sentence using apostrophe. This is the doll of Seema. I have this phrase, the doll of Seema. So Seema is the person who possesses or owns the doll. So Seema is the person who possesses or owns the doll. So I will attach a hook after Seema, and whenever I have this hook, I use an S, Seema's, And what does Seema own? Doll. So Seema's doll. So the doll of Seema will be replaced by Seema's doll. This is Seema's doll. So the doll of Seema, the doll of Seema is replaced by Seema's doll. This is the apostrophe and it is used to show belonging or possession, that Seema possesses the doll or the doll belongs to Seema. It is the watch of my father. So once again, I have the watch of my father. So over here, my father is the person who owns it, who owns the watch. So my father is the person who owns it. Now I will attach a hook after father. So remember, I'll not attach a hook after my and father both. I'll attach the hook only after father. And then I put an S, my father's, and what does he own or possess? Watch. So my father's watch. It is my father's watch. So the watch of my father becomes my father's watch. Sachin Tendulkar is the pride of India. So once again, it will be the pride of India will become India's pride. So an easy way to see is when we have something of something. So the pride of India. So in the apostrophe, it will be, first we'll have India, apostrophe S, and then pride. Remember, I am skipping the everywhere. So the pride of India becomes India's pride. Sachin Tendulkar is India's pride. So can you write this sentence using an apostrophe? This is the car of my uncle. Now, once again, I have the car of my uncle. So first I will have my uncle, who is the owner. I'll put an apostrophe and then an S and the car. So will it be my uncle's the car? No, my uncle's car. I don't write the here. So my uncle's car. This is my uncle's car. This is my uncle's car. So the car of my uncle, this huge phrase is replaced by my uncle's car. So apostrophe is making this sentence concise. The speech of the principal was inspiring. Can you rewrite this sentence using an apostrophe? The speech of the principal was inspiring. So the speech of the principal. Now what is there after of the principal? So we will have the principal. Remember, this the is not omitted. I need to write this the. So the before principal is written here. The principal, apostrophe S, the principles, and what is coming before of the speech? So I'll have speech. The principal's speech was inspiring. The principal's speech was inspiring. So this phrase, the speech of the principal, is replaced by the principal's speech was inspiring. So this is how you can use apostrophe to show possession or belonging of nouns or pronouns. If you like this video, then subscribe to our channel. You can also register for free at deltastep.com to get all the learning resources as per CBSE, ICSE, IB, Cambridge or any other curriculum. Over 5,000 amazing lectures on maths, science, English and social science Our unique interactive video technology keeps you engaged, and our iDictionary feature allows you to quickly revise any concept. Master each topic at your own pace with our adaptive practice technology and 1 million plus questions. Get instant answers and detailed solutions. Be exam ready by taking unlimited mock tests, performance analysis along with actionable feedback, personal tutors to resolve the slightest of your doubts. And that's not all. You can also win exciting prizes like PlayStations, iPads, watches, and many more, along with certificates through our Earn As You Learn program. So at DeltaStep.com, learning is not just fun and easy, it is rewarding too. So register for free now.